says the legal and structural barriers compound the situation, leading to increased cases of attacks on the dignity of individuals and deliberate denial of services to individuals on the basis of their sexual orientation.
How do we then innovate beyond that? Not just talking about the problems, but looking at various tools that or innovations and models that other countries have adopted. Like one of the discussions that we have right now is to look at social contracting as one option that can actually be looked at and interrogated. We have countries like India that have adopted, mostly in Asia, have adopted interventions that are targeted at certain groups that are highly at risk, such as sex workers, people living with the disease like PLHIV, and these are really targeted interventions that you actually contract as government, you contract civil society organization to do the work for you. But that obviously entails that we need to package those services, we need to have trainings and proper trainings in place. So this is what we are trying to identify, where do we start? But ultimately we want to develop a roadmap that will help us to be able to develop a proper framework that can help us to address those gaps.
NANASO is implementing a national advocacy agenda for civil society to shape the narrative and legal space of engagement with government and other key partners, with a major focus on holding the state accountable for state health care in the country.
Because ultimately we want results. We want to end the AIDS as an epidemic, to achieve epidemic control. But that will be influenced by how we finance our activities, how we keep on investing. And here I want really to call upon all partners in the country, development partners, UNAIDS, USAID, PEPFAR, that have been working with us, and we want to always say we thank them for the support that they've given us. But we also want to tell them that it's not over yet. We need to get to the end. We need to finish this race, and civil society must always be in the equation of their funding to be able to access to provide the necessary services, essential services that is required for different groups that we have been talking about that have been identified here.
Stigma, Charonda says, is the biggest problem that the workshop seeks to address, as most people struggle to deal with it, including healthcare workers. Evelyn Paulus, NBC News, Oshiva Rongo.